The Antonio Project presents IMO Classification of Gas Carrier, Part 1.
Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. After several parts video about LNG cargo, at this opportunity, I will continue to share about gas containment system for transporting gas from the gas production terminal to the consumer, which is separated by the ocean. The rules and regulations for the design and construction of gas carrier rely on practical ship design codified by the International Maritime Organization or IMO. However, all ships from June 1986 started to be constructed according to the International Code for the Construction and Equipment of Ships Carrying Liquefied Gases in Bulk, or the IGC Code. This video is part 1 about IMO classification of gas carrier. Anyway, before we continue to enjoy my animation video, don't forget to click subscribe button. Your contribution by subscribe my channel will much give me additional booster fuel to keep my channel selling in YouTube network, to share tiny knowledge and information about seafarer world. And next, let's the animation, let's go!
Types of gas carrier. Natural gases, according to their physical and chemical properties, are normally carried in liquid state. Thus, gas carrier ships can be classified under below mentioned categories. 1. Fully pressurized. Fully pressurized ships are the ships with the capability of carrying gases up to 3,500 cubic meter. These ships carry the gas in spherical or cylindrical steel tanks regardless of temperature or pressure control. These are designed for a maximum working pressure of 17.5 kg square centimeter and a minimum working temperature at minus 45 degrees Celsius. 2. Semi-pressurized and refrigerated. Semi-pressurized and semi-refrigerated ships consist of semi-refrigerated plant with a high design pressure for the tanks capable of transporting up to 5,000 cubic meter gas. The tank used in these ships are cylindrical in shape and are designed for maximum working pressure of 8.5 kg per square centimeter and a minimum working temperature of minus 10 degrees Celsius. Semi-pressurized and fully refrigerated ships are capable of transporting the gas up to 15,000 cubic meter in cylindrical or spherical tanks, which are designed for a maximum working pressure of 5 kg square centimeter and a minimum working temperature of minus 48 degrees Celsius. Reliquefaction plant fitted in these ships can cool or heat the gas during gas filling in or discharging from tanks respectively. 3. Fully refrigerated. Fully refrigerated ships are very large gas carriers, capable of carrying 15,000 to 85,000 cubic meter gas and best suited for long voyages. Tanks used in these ships are capable of bearing a maximum working pressure of about 0.28 kg per square centimeter and a minimum working temperature of minus 50 degrees Celsius. The gas code divides gas carrier into 4 categories according to the hazard rating of the cargoes for the carriage of which the ship is certified. 1. Type 1G ships is a gas carrier intended to transport products that require maximum preventive measure to preclude the escape of such cargo. For the example, chlorine, methyl bromide. 2. Type 2G ships is a gas carrier intended to transport products that require significant preventive measures to preclude the escape of such cargo. For the example, ethane, LNG or methane, and propane. 3. Type 2 PG ships is a gas carrier of 150 meters in length or less intended to transport products which require significant preventive measure to preclude escape of such cargo. And where the products are carried in independent type C tanks designed for a MARVS or the maximum allowable relief valve setting of a cargo tank of at least 0.7 megapascal gates and a cargo containment system designed temperature of minus 55 degrees Celsius or above. Note that a ship of this description but over 150 meters in length is to be considered a type 2G ship. 4. Type 3G ship is a gas carrier intended to carry product which require moderate preventive measures to preclude the escape of such cargo, for the example, refrigerant gases, nitrogen. IMO classification of gas carrier divided into two types, independent tanks and integral tanks. Independent tanks are completely self-supporting and do not form of the ship's hull structure. Tank structure consists of primary barrier. Primary barrier is first layer of the cargo containment to keep the cargo in place, or cargo tank. Tank supporter, a structure to hold or support cargo containment in place. Secondary barrier, the liquid resisting outer element of a cargo containment system designed to afford temporary containment of a leakage of liquid cargo through the primary barrier, and to prevent the lowering of temperature of the ship structure to an unsafe level. Insulation, low thermal conductivity material for reducing heat transfer between two surfaces, such as liquid cargo and outside weather. Second type is integral tanks. Integral tanks form a structural part of the ship's hull and are influenced by the same load which stress the hull structure. Tank structure consists of primary barrier. Secondary barrier. Primary insulation. Secondary insulation. Independent tanks divided into three types: type A, type B, and type C. Type A vessel, maximum working pressure of 700 millibar, equipped with full secondary barrier. Type B vessel, maximum working pressure of 700 millibar, equipped with partial secondary barrier. The vessels included into B type are spherical or boss type and IHI SPB type. Next is type C vessels, the maximum working pressure of 2000 millibar and without secondary barrier being installed. The vessels included into C type are cylindrical type and bilobe type. For integral tank, the vessel is using membrane tank with maximum working pressure of 700 millibar and equipped with full secondary barrier. The vessels included into integral tank are membrane type GTT number 96, membrane type Mark 3, and membrane type GTT GS1, which is combination between GTT number 96 and Mark 3. Independent tank type A, prismatic self-supported tank. The type A vessel in general appraisal are box-shaped or prismatic cargo tanks in order to fit to the hold space. It must have a full secondary barrier based on classical ship structure rules. This requirement provides a redundancy to prevent any possible leakage caused by a rupture of the tank primary barrier. For Type A tanks, the hull structures are permitted to be designed for cargoes with boiling temperature not lower than minus 55 degrees Celsius, which is not a realistic alternative for LNG purposes, being more adequate for propane and ammonia transportation. Type A constructed basically of flat plates and surfaces. The maximum allowable tank design pressure in the vapor space is 700 millibar, meaning that cargoes must be transported in a fully refrigerated condition at near atmospheric pressure. Type A cargo tanks are self-supported tanks demanding internal conventional stiffening. Usually, they are coated and surrounded by a film of foam insulation. On some ships, the space between the cargo tank, or sometimes referred to as the primary barrier and the secondary barrier, is known as the hull space. When flammable cargoes are being carried, these spaces must be filled with inert gas to prevent flammable atmosphere being created in the event of primary barrier leakage. This is cross-section of Type A prismatic self-supported tank. The construction are as follow. Ballast tank and double bottom tank. Bulkhead and foam insulation. Primary barrier and secondary barrier. Hold space and cargo pump. For this vessel, the IGC code requires that whatever may be the secondary barriers, it must be able to hold the tank liquid for 15 days. This type of tank usually found in the refrigerated ships used for transportation of liquefied petroleum gas or LPG. Independent tank type B, EHI SPB type. SPB LNGC comply with IMO Type B requirements by using aluminum alloy self-supporting prismatic tanks, proven for its reliability. According to IHI, the prismatic tank is divided into four compartments by bulkheads LNG leak-proof. Thus, according to the technology, it is predicted that the local frequency of the liquid motion within the cargo tank is not affected by the vessel motion frequency. Thus, it is expected that it could not happen any resonance between the movement of liquid cargo and the ship's movement, being supposedly possible to load the ships with any level of the cryogenic. It also avoids, in principle, the occurrence of load stratification that may take place due to the sudden mix of LNG with different densities, compositions, and heat capacities in the bottom of the ship's tank or rollover. One of the characteristics of the SPB prismatic tank is its free shapes, since it is constructed with stiffened plates. This allows constructing the ship's hulls considering the best hull performance, given a design condition, draft, beam, etc., and designing cargo tank to follow the hull contour afterwards, leading to a compact LNG carrier with reliable hull shape. The stiffened plates used in its structure are made of aluminum alloy and covered by an insulation layer of polyurethane foam. Its cargo tank is supported by a special type of reinforced plywood and subdivided by a tight bulkhead, working as a center line for the liquid content and swash bulkhead into four spaces. So, the natural frequency of the liquid movement inside tank is different from that of ship's motion, eliminating chances of resonance between the liquid cargo and ship movements. Following is the structure of EHI SPB tank. Ballast tank and insulation. Centerline bulkhead and swash bulkhead. Inner hull and tank dome. One important characteristic of AHI SPB is the deck that is completely flat from side to side, with no obstacle on the deck when compared with membrane and extruded spar on the deck most LNG ship. This contributes to less wind resistance, thus with less power consumption, easy maintenance, easy navigability and maneuverability.
This is the end of part 1 animation video. Part 2 animation video will be released soon. Don't forget to click like, subscribe and share button. Also, click bell button for the automatic notification of my newly released video. Thank you for watching and your subscription. See you in my another video. Bye-bye.
Thank you for watching my video to the end of the slide. If you have any question or advice, please don't be hesitate to write in the comment below. Sharing knowledge is the easiest way to do charity. If you think that my video is helpful, don't forget to click like and share button. The Antonio Project.